boys and left the girls alive. Allah, today they have taken both the boys and the girls. يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَيَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. Nabi alayhi salam said, مَنْ ظَلَمَ قِيدَ الشِّبْرٍ مِّنَ الْأَرْضِ تُوِقَهُ مِّنْ سَبْعِ أَرْضٍ. He who usurps a palm's length of land, he who usurps the land of someone this much year, تُوِقَهُ مِّنْ سَبْعِ أَرْضٍ. My mother Aisha narrates it, Bukhari and Muslim have it. He will be made, the seven earths will be made a necklace, and it will be then shoved down his throat. And let me tell you, the system of the justice of Allah is not like this world. That a man knows he's perpetrated the crime. He understands, but because there isn't tangible evidence against him, he walks out innocent. Nabi alayhi salam said it in the riwayat of Bukhari, إِنَّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ إِلَيَّ. Listen, you present to me with your arguments. وَلَعَلَّ بَعْضُكُمْ أَن يَكُونَ أَلْحَنَ بِحُجَّتِهِ مِنْ بَعْضٍ. Some of yous are more articulate and more profound, and you come across more convincing than others. فَأَقْضِي بِنَحْوِ مَا أَسْمَعُ. I'm a human, I take your evidence face value with your skills of convincing. But rest assured, make no mistake, if you know it's not yours, my decision and verdict in your favor doesn't give you the rights to take that. I am only allotting a share of Jahannam for you. That is the system of the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That every person will be brought to the book and hisab will prevail. What does Allah say? وَكَذَلِكَ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we narrate to you the tales of the previous prophets by virtue of which you relate to their lives and take support from their happenings. And it is with this spirit that I speak to you about the life of a Nabi whom the Quran speaks about. But before that, let me touch one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيُمْلِي لِلظَّالِمِ. What a hadith. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah has no place for an oppressor. However, Allah's system of dismantling oppression is gradual. Allah is very tolerant. These are the words of the hadith. Allah is very tolerant with an oppressor. Allah grants respite. Allah grants clemency. Allah grants leeway. Study the oppression of Fir'aun. He had ordered the general massacre of children prior to the birth of Musa alayhi salam. That was one crime. Again, in his foolish notion to deter the overall plan of Allah. فَالْتَقَطَهُ آلُ فِرْعَوْنَ لِيَكُونَ لَهُمْ عَدُوًا وَحَزَنًا. The child for whom he killed thousands of children, he picks up that own child. But that's the planning of Allah, and Allah wants to show him blatantly, you cannot change my planning. Subsequent to Musa's growing up and becoming a Nabi and 600,000 magicians accepting his message, again he realizes that his power is now at stake. His position is in jeopardy. For a second time, he commands the massacre of children across the board. Across the board. There is a misconception that as Muslims, we cannot coexist with other faiths. Wallah, throughout the decades and the times, we lived with our fellow non-Muslim citizens. And they flourished and prospered within our countries. And I have spoken about that. My topic is not that. I just touch on this and move on. Fir'aun ordered the massacre for the second time, for the second time, amongst the people that he massacred and he oppressed. Now again, I'm tying it up with Allah's grace, Allah's allowance. Not that Allah condones it, but Allah gives leeway. Nabi alayhi salam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيُمْلِي. Allah just leaves him. Allah unleashes his reins. Allah unleashes his power. So he goes full out. He goes for the jugular, he goes for the kill. It doesn't hurt him to see children. You see footage and you cry, and yet it makes no difference to him. He goes for the kill and Allah allows him to go that way. Hizqil, there was a person amongst the tribe of Fir'aun who accepted Islam, who concealed his iman, and then his wife accepted iman. One day she was busy combing the hair of the daughter of Fir'aun, and the comb fell down. When you talk of oppression, when you talk of gruesome murder, when you talk of unjustifiable crimes, when you talk of no merit, to then speak about the oppression becomes oppression. How more can it be? How great a crime can there be? In the era of democracy, in the period of liberation, in the time we were hearing in the papers now, where two children, or I don't know, three, they killed a rat and they mercilessly abused it. and they have been put in jail. Hi Allah, we cry to you Allah, our children die, there's nobody to take them to justice Allah. One insignificant creature, we respect the sentiments that courtesy be shown to animals. But three people who ill-treated one rat could find place in the prison, and thousands who perpetrate the crime against humanity, the international world is silent. Brothers, if it doesn't make your heart tear, I don't know if there's any heart left. I don't know if there's anything left. She was combing the hair of the daughter of Fir'aun and her comb fell down. She said, Ta'isa Fir'aun, what an oppressive dictator this man is. Immediately this woman was brought in the court of Fir'aun. You call me an oppressor? You call me a dictator? Man rabbuki ayyatuhal khaina? Who is your Lord? She says, my Lord is Allah and he is your Lord. Ila hadhal haddi, in front of me you deny my divinity. She says, I believe in one Allah. فَقَالَ الْحُرَّاسِ, he points to the guards and he says, إِحْرِقُوهَا وَحْرِقُوا أَبَنَاءَهَا أَمَامَهَا. Listen, burn this woman alive and do me a favor, bring her children and first burn her children before her eye. This woman, I was reading today the riwayat of Ibn Majah, بَابٌ الصَّبْرِ عَلَى الْبَلَىٰ, the patience and perseverance on difficulties and adversity. In Ibn Majah on page 291, this woman was killed. Her children were killed in front of her. They were roasted in front of her. My Nabi said, when he went for Mi'raj, as he was ascending to the heavens, he said, Ya Jibril, ma hadhihi rihu tayyiba. Jibril, what a fragrance I get. Where am I passing by? Jibril said, you pass in the grave of the slave of Fir'aun, who died giving her life for the pleasure of Allah. Next to her are her sons, and next to her is her husband. Decades and centuries have lapsed. When my Nabi's conveyance ascends to the heavens, he gets the brilliant smell emitting from the grave. My sister, today you adorn yourself with the deodorants of today, and you impress men and you come across seductive. Allah alone knows when your grave will open and mine will open, what will happen. But here stands a woman. What I'm saying, Allah gives grace, Allah gives respite, Allah gives chance. Then what did Nabi alayhi salam say? ثُمَّ إِذَا أَخَذَهُ لَمْ يُفْلِتْهُ. Then Allah grabs that dictator. You know, one is, I say this is an oppressor and he is a dictator. Allah himself by his own admission says Fir'aun was a dictator. Fir'aun was an oppressor. Can you imagine the clemency of Allah? إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَىٰ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Verily he rebelled on the earth. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا. He divided the people into categories. يَسْتَضَعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِّنْهُمْ. He said the Bani Israel have been created to serve and we've been created to rule. There is pleasure living in this world if four people exist. And if four people don't exist, trust me, there's no pleasure. بِعِلْمِ الْعُلَمَاء وَبِعَدْلِ الْأُمَرَاء وَبِسَخَاوَةِ الْأَغْنِيَاء وَبِدُعَاءِ الْفُقَرَاء. بِعِلْمِ الْعُلَمَاء, if there are scholars, learned divine scholars, if they exist and they are just rulers and they are generous wealthy people and they are pious poor people. وَلَوْلَ الْعُلَمَاء, if there are no pious scholars, لَهَلَكَ الْجُهَلَاء, then the masses will go astray. وَلَوْلَ عَدْلُ الْأُمَرَاء لَأَكَلَ النَّاسُ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا. And if there is no justice and there is no fairness and there is no equity, then the mighty will thrive at the hands of the weak. They will abuse, they will exploit, and that is what this world has become. That there is absent, there are no just rulers left in this world. Allah, where are we living, Allah? In what a time has our eyes opened up, Allah? وَلَوْلَا سَخَاوَةُ الْأَغْنِيَا. And if there isn't the wealthy, generous people, لَهَلَكَ الْفُقَرَاء, the poor will suffer. وَلَوْلَا دُعَاءُ الْفُقَرَاءَ لَخَرَبَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهِنْ. And if there isn't the supplication of the poor, the sky and the earth, both will be destroyed. Brothers, like I mentioned, that Allah's system is, then Nabi alayhi salam read the verse, وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَىٰ وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. Allah gives respite, Allah gives grace, Allah gives allowance. Then Allah grabs, this is the words of the Quran, إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ. The grasp of your Lord is intense. The grip of your Lord is very strong. Then when Allah grips, then Allah grips this Fir'aun in the center of the ocean. And what do the scholars write? This tyrant dictator who was responsible for the murder and the killing of thousands of people. مات ملك مصر بعيدا عن عرشه بعيدا عن سلطانه. لا طبيب يداويه ولا صديق يواسيه ولا عين تبكيه. Far from his kingdom, far from his dominion, in the depth of the ocean where no doctors are around him.